Is this yours?
Yes.
Okay.
This is a video that was suggested to me on YouTube. Is it the last one?
It's the last one.
Oh, yeah. This is a video that was suggested to me on YouTube. Look at this. 123,000 thumbs up, 666 down. People that are into this love this. This is for those that are into language and accents. Here we have a London accent all the way from the 14th to the 21st century and the progression and sort of how it changes. In order to hear what a London accent sounded like in the 14th century, we'll skip forward to like the minute 40 mark, somewhere around there. Yeah, right around here. And give us some volume and just hit play. So this is the like 1346, 1300s.
Ready and never to fall apart, dusky shape and mud and bane. And the wool was teeth about him. And we sighed on thy father, your wool hath moths. Tath moths in the arms, tath moths in the shoulders, tath moths in the elbows, and not the wool alone. Your hair hath moths, your head hath them. He was 20, should say, and he was no child then. My father then sat up and said, if that he have moths, then to having moths is to bane myself. And he knew not what child I have me bane, if not myself.
Go ahead, Will.
Did we told him anything more?
What's he telling you?
I don't know what he's talking about. Something about moths.
Moths. Moths. They're talking about moths in the coat. And the guy's saying, if I do have moths, I'll burn myself. It's wild, right? That's English in 1346. Hmm. Now go somewhere in the middle of the video. Maybe, yeah, sure. So we're all the way up to 1706. Let's give this a shot. Shout out Weekender, by the way.
To the ground, and the butchers was burned to the ground, and the greengrocers was burned to the ground. And this was in the middle of London. And if you climbed up on the roof, you could see it from here. The flames would have been 100 yards high, and it was windy, blowing winds, and you could see the fire bright across the sky. And where we are here, the wind was blowing the fire right towards us, so you couldn't
What
see
do you think
sun.
Now? 1706, no problem, right?
It has like Irish tinge.
Right.
A little bit.
But you can discern every single word.
Yeah.
By 1706. Now go somewhere earlier, go to like 1500, right around there. Yeah. So this is the in-between.
We saw all sorts there. I snared rabbits to sell down the market. So I never put my knife in anything bigger than a rabbit till I was 20.
Discernible.
Father insisted on
yeah.
it.
Yeah. I don't mind this one.
Slaughtering. But the owns came down to me snare. I know the spot they ran through. I put a snare in this hedge. The owns came down to it all morning and found there was a weasel in there, still alive.
Weasel?
And
weasel.
Weasels are vicious things. So I got
it's almost
the biggest,
like greatest, ASMR.
Longest stick I could find and knocked it over the head. Untied it and threw it in some brambles.
He knocked it over the head. Amazing recordings. Amazing recordings. And
yeah.
You might as well go all the way to the end as well and show, maybe, yeah, here we go, 2006.
Family. So we used to go all round the houses on Christmas Eve singing carols because all but one of us was lucky enough to have Christmas off work, Christmas Eve off work. So we went round singing, and when I was about 20, it snowed in some parts of London on Christmas Eve. This was back in the 60s, and it snowed properly too. It wasn't just a thin layer, it was proper snow that your foot crunched right into. And me and my sister never seen anything like it. That's your Aunt Beryl. We'd never seen proper snow before, apart from on the telly. And in pictures, you can sort of tell how
this
hard
is,
crunchy it is from looking at.
There's a very specific region to this, because this sounds like Ricky Gervais in a way.
Well, it's London.
Like his...
It's a London accent.
London. Okay.
Yeah. It's a London accent. And he's got these charts on screen for those that are just listening that sort of break down some of the words and sounds that are typical and in that era, how they're pronounced. And so there's actually a meaning, of course, to this, to these slides, talking about how diphthongs and year and there and how these things are pronounced. It's all very interesting. And they can go back and forth between eras and there can be trends and things like that. But you can go check out the video and see everywhere in between and without captions turned on, you can see how far back you can go while still understanding what's being said.
And this is the one guy who's doing it all?
No, I don't believe so. No, no, no. It's links to a couple of books about the reconstruction of earlier English pronunciation linked in the description. I think
it's
I think it's a collection.
Oh, okay.
Of, go to the description. Let's just be sure on this. English pronunciation. I recommend Cambridge. Keep going down. Oh, the chapters on. Oh, no, no, no. Yeah, these are recordings.
They're really good recordings.
They're record. Yeah, but I think they're recordings like from audiobooks and recent publications where the expert or the expertise would be to deliver it in the same way that it was written.
Yeah.
Because you would take a text and then dialogue. I'm pretty sure this was going on. But anyway, I'm not going to lie, Will. What happened was he put a link in the video at the very beginning that said, if you want to go straight to the dialogue, go forward in the video.
Right.
As opposed to listening to the backstory. So that's what I did. And then I started reading each slide and just focusing solely on the accents as opposed to where they were sourced from.
Recordings.
Okay. So he... So
yes. Yeah, links to a couple books about the reconstruction of earlier English pronunciation are linked in the description.
Simon Roper.
Anyway, it's a very cool video. And 3 million views, which is a lot for his channel. He has 160,000 subscribers, but I find it to be really interesting.
Mm-hmm.
And you might find it to be interesting as well. So go give it a crack. Thank you to everybody who joined us here today. Thank you to everybody that gave us the super chats. We really do appreciate it. Thank you to Mo, even though he had the hard out today. We appreciate his presence. Thank you to Will, obviously. And thank you to all the amazing stories and amazing people doing things on the internet, giving us... something that's worthwhile to talk about every single day. We will be back. We're always back. Things happen. We tell you about things that happened and are happening, and we'll do the same tomorrow. Thanks again.